Today, our video is gonna be talking about what we're doing here at the V35 project and just how we achieve these looks, just so there's no confusion about what is going on. So, two lenses, we're gonna use this Schneider Xenon 25 millimeter as our comparison today. Easy to see what's going on with these. So this is a standard one. And with our Schneiders, we took the emulation of the old Cine Xenons from the 60s. So we analyzed as much footage as we could from that, broke down everything that we liked about that set, and then tried to print that on this lens. And not just this lens, but the whole set of these Schneiders. But for today, we're just gonna show you and demonstrate with just the 25. So, question we get asked here a lot is, well, we could just do this with a mattebox filter. Well, hate to break it to you, but you can't. What we're doing is so much deeper than just filtration would ever allow that we kind of want to break that myth right now. Maybe some degree you could almost maybe get some part of a halation thing to be close, but the way we're doing our halation internally, just it would never actually match. And what we're doing in terms of keeping these consistent is totally different. So how do we make this lens look like the old version of this lens? And keep in mind, on this test, it might be a little bit subtle because there's not much of an optical difference between the old Cine Xenon and the new modern Xenons. This would be a little bit more obvious on something like our CNE to rangefinder, which is a much more extreme tuning. So let's just really quick break down what we're doing. So what is an optical retune? Well, we're taking all the lenses apart, and it's a mixture of, one, some personal proprietary wizardry that we're doing with our lens designers, but for the most part, and it's no industry secret, we're messing around with spacing of elements, air gaps, internal paint to create internal reflection, coatings, things like that. And with all that, we are affecting certain parts of the image. Now, what we're looking at specifically that we're trying to do when we're looking at taking vintage lenses and making them modern is there's a lot of commonality between other lenses, but there was some difference based on the optical design and the coating, say between an Olympus OM and something like the Cine Xenon. But that being said, what we're really trying to do here is affect a couple things. Contrast, more flares, more edge fall off. So we're getting a little bit muddier towards the edges. Maybe a little bit of softness wide open, more textured bokeh, maybe getting some swirls and some distortion going on. And that is really what we're trying to do, is create a lot of these lens properties that quote unquote are fixed with modern lenses. But those things are character heavy, and that's what we're trying to print back onto these modern lenses. So we shot a little test in here, which is the 25 on the V-Raptor 16x9, and we're gonna show you quite a few things here that demonstrate kind of the subtlety of what we're doing, but also when you start looking, it's actually not that subtle, and that translates to your final image. So first, what we're gonna do is just show you a chart. Now, the center sharpness is pretty close to the same, but if you start looking at where chromatic aberration starts happening and how we've shifted around some of the chromatic and spherical aberration, you can see that in the center when you're cropped in 300%. Now, if we're just looking at the center, there's not much of a difference to be had, but if you start zooming in and going towards the edge of frame, say on our Northwest camera logo, at T21, T28, and 4, you can see just how dramatic that fall off becomes, and the out of focus area becomes completely different. Now, if you're looking at the line pairs, you can see there's some more halation, a little bit more separation, and things like that, that when we start showing you examples here in real life, it's very easy to see how that translates. So let's take a quick look at some chart stuff while we're talking and finish up, and we'll come back to the next thing. Okay, now let's see what that looks like in real life. So we shot both of these lenses at T2-1 at the exact same distance, so they're both focused at 24 inches. Our lights are all at the same place in the background. Nothing has changed. So if you zoom in and look at the bokeh around the lights, while subtle, there is a little bit more texture and onion ringing going on the V35 Project Tuning version versus a standard Xenon. Now, if we go further and we look at the edge of frame in this plant, we're gonna see that a lot of this bokeh, like on a modern lens, is very creamy and the out of focus area is like really soft. We're adding a little bit more busyness or texture into that bokeh, and it's very apparent when you look at some of the branches on the edge of frame here, which kind of lend to some of that swirly nature that'll go on if you're seeing things out in the edge of frame, if you're shooting heavy foliage, things like that. But also, this helps to create that three-dimensionality when we're putting people, you know, in the middle 80% of the frame. And that's what we like to see, is really a nice clean separation between faces and background that really creates some interest. So next we're just gonna talk about contrast really quick. And this one is pretty straightforward. We're just gonna show you the exact same frame, one, then the other, and just show you a screen grab of the waveform of both, just so you can see that there is something going on in terms of our black levels and how we have reduced contrast in the V35 project tunings of the Schneiders. Last but not least, the flares. Now, to start, the Xenons already have, in terms of a modern lens, a pretty fun flare, all things considered. If you compare them to CP3s, CNEs, other lenses in that market, I honestly think the Schneiders have probably the best starting place from something that's actually pretty interesting. But we've taken that and made it what I would say a little bit more interesting. And you'll see this in terms of more warmth in the flares, more streaky rays coming out. It's almost like the orbs going across frame are now more blended together and feel more cohesive. We've taken some of the saturation down out of some of these like really highly saturated ones on the modern lens, which comes from a very good multi-coating on the coatings. So, and that's one thing we do on all of our lenses, is really try to hit it to make these flares seem like that really romantic, nostalgic, vintage look. Okay, so that's the overview of what we do and how we tune and why what we're doing is not just simply the addition of a mattebox filter and why you could never emulate this with any glass in front or behind. Now, there are some things out there that we will be selling, like a module 8 tuner that you can take to expand on what we're doing and create more interest. But in terms of just filtration front or rear, nothing you're gonna do is even gonna come close to what we're doing inside the lens to create a truly vintage emulated look on a modern lens. So thanks for watching and learning a little bit on the technical side about what we do with our lenses to create that truly beautiful vintage look. See you on the next one.